feels so good to finally jump off with my own podcast. Now, this is a long time coming, and I appreciate you guys for just being involved, being down for this journey with me. This is a Spot Wrinkle Blemish podcast where we talk about a lot of things. Most of you guys may know me. I got another show where we're able to talk a little bit more reckless. But let me just take you behind the mic on Spot Wrinkle Blemish, man. It started off really with me at a barbershop talking to a barber. I won't say a barber's name, but he was kind of telling me about, you know, how, well, I asked him, hey, what church you go to? He's like, man, I go to the same church every week. He's like, I do church at my home. I don't need to go to no church. And his whole argument behind it was that church is anywhere that you go. And I get all of that. But then I asked him, what about fellowship? What about connecting with other believers? What about growing together and holding each other accountable? And he didn't have anything to say for that. His response was, he does all that himself. And I began to really think about just how real church hurt was. I was going to call the podcast the Church Hurt Podcast. But it goes deeper than that, man. I come across so many people who have had a lot of experiences with wanting to give up on God. A lot of experience with wanting to give up on church, period. And so I asked God, like, what can I do? How can I use my gifts? And so there came the birth of Spot Wrinkle Blemish Media. Just to highlight who we are, you know, what we stand for, and the things that really matter. The church is not perfect. Ephesians 5:27 says that he might present himself to a glorious church, not having a spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. You know, the church is not perfect. A lot of people expect the church to be perfect. They expect the people to be perfect, especially in this day and age that we live in, where you got prominent, like high up pastors, ministers falling, like showing flaws that a lot of people think they shouldn't fall. And I have a lot of pastor friends, a lot of people who lead churches, who lead bodies of Christ, and I know for a fact pastors are not perfect. Now, I think I've heard many of them say that people think they have a kind of a cheat code on how to live righteous. No, they come through the same trials, the same things that people who are not in the pulpit come across. And so I just want to encourage people through this entire series, this entire podcast, for however many come along, to not give up on God. You may be out there listening to this and you may have left your church or left the church, quote unquote, but you still got a soft spot for God because you know God is real, right? He's done some things in your life that you can't explain without saying, you know what? God is in control, but you're not at the point where you want to put hope in church. And I can dig that. One of the things that I learned through my hurt, and I'll share my little testimony as well in this introductory episode, was that I learned not to put hope into any one man, if that makes sense, right? There, you can follow, right? And there are shepherds and leaders, but men, people will let you down. That's just reality. People will let you down. And I think I heard someone say, I heard a pastor say, don't follow me, follow Christ. And that's real. And I didn't understand it. But that's real, because you will learn that people will fall. People's hurts, pains, their situations will fall. They go through stuff too, is what I'm saying. And so that's the purpose of this. I want to just share kind of, that was my little 5-minute introduction for the show and kind of what kind of came about, where it came from. And I want to take a moment just to share my story in this little short podcast episode, right? I grew up in church. A lot of people know what church I grew up in the Detroit metro area. I grew up in Pontiac, but I always kind of traveled down to the Detroit area for church. And the church I went to probably for the first 18 years of my life, on and off, and I've gone to other churches that they've opened up. You know, it was a wonderful church. Still is, to my knowledge. It's still blessing a lot of people. Still encouraging a lot of people. Still helping a lot of people break through chains, bondages, yokes destroyed. And I've seen many miracles come from this church. I think I reached a season in my life where I was past 18, getting ready to be married. You know, I got married at 25. And I was seeking counseling at the church. And at 25, you know, you're still young. You don't quite understand. You know, someone hurt me. And I went to seek counseling at the church. And the counselor, who was a man who's no longer in ministry to my knowledge, kind of said to me, you know, that it was my fault, more or less, what happened to me. Yes, it was wrong what happened to you, but you could have prevented it by doing X, Y, and Z. And I felt like there should have been a lot more accountability for the other individual who also went to the church. And it really hardened my heart towards the whole church situation. I felt like I did the right thing by praying. I felt like I did the right thing by going and seeking godly counsel. But I got blamed. I got blamed in a situation where I didn't do wrong. And, you know, as a young man, even though I grew up in church, I was kind of learning how to rely on God on my own. I really felt hardened towards that situation. And so I didn't physically leave, but I left mentally from that church. And my heart towards God got a little harder. And then I wound up going to another church where I was able to kind of start fresh, start new. And I met other people who have gone through similar situations. At all the churches that I've gone to, I've met people who have left their church because of something that may have gone on. Maybe it's a new season in their life, maybe growth, maybe an incident with the pastor, maybe somebody did you wrong, right? But I've met so many people just as I kind of, you know, ventured out to grow at a different church or a different church community who, you know, still harbor or hold on to a little bit of hurt, you know? And I thought it was always interesting just coming across people's stories. People's stories are interesting to me, and that's where I want to come into the Spot Wrinkle Blemish podcast is a safe space where people can share their stories. I knew in my journey that I still needed God, but partially because I grew up without a father in the home. And so my access to God was the counsel that I needed when my mom couldn't be there. Now, my mom never was not there. She was always there, but I had to seek God. And even she'll tell you, she's a minister. She'll tell you, she needed God. And so the same thing. So I've seen God in so many areas of my life, from my marriage to my kids to my businesses to anything art related, anything, my jobs, just safety on safety, grace on grace. And so I felt wisdom in me not to give up on God, even though I felt hurt by a church. Now, different seasons grow and you go to different churches, right? Because and who you may be in this season of your life may not be where God has called you. Does that make sense? Because a lot of some churches are called to specific avenues or specific beings. There are churches who are called to do more community-related things, right? And if that's not where you are and you need to grow spiritually, you need to have a kind of a realistic conversation. Doesn't mean anything is wrong with said church. It just means that where God has called them is a little bit different, right? And you shouldn't, and I want to encourage people not to keep banging your head against the wall when the vision of the church doesn't match you, and kind of look for things that could be wrong. Eh, you know, the church is the church, and they're going to be who they're going to be and who God called them to be, you know? So don't try to make it to what it's not. they have to be obedient to God, just like you have to be obedient to God. So that means you have to make a decision. Am I going to stay? Is my family going to stay there? Or am I going to have a real conversation and respectfully say, hey, I need to grow in a different area. I need spiritual growth. I need community connection. I need whatever. I've heard people leave for because of the praise team. I've heard someone leave a church because they didn't have Wi-Fi. They didn't offer free Wi-Fi. I have. It's out there, man. It's out there, man. You know, the church has changed. You know, I'm 40, and the church has changed. So I've seen a lot in the churches, from the traditional, what you wearing, what you got on, put on more clothes, to, it's not that bad, to, hey, anything goes. Ripped jeans on the stage, open shirts, anything goes. Just worship God. So I've seen a lot of different phases of the church. I've seen a lot of different people. But I've come across a lot of people who deal with church hurt in my years. And I found one of the first things to do to overcome church hurt is to acknowledge and really just validate your feelings. You know, the first step to overcoming church hurt is that, right? Yeah, I've been hurt. I've been wronged. Somebody did me wrong. This situation wasn't right. I don't feel good about this situation. Once you recognize the pain, once you recognize kind of the disappointment and the confusion from the negative experiences within the church, then it will allow yourself to move past without any judgment, because you don't want to be in a position where you start judging, talking down, or talking about the pastor, or talking about the man or woman of God. You don't want to be in a position of that, because that opens you up for the wrong stuff, right? Revelations 12:11 says, and they overcome by the blood of the Lamb, the word of their testimony. Understand that your testimony, your story, is a powerful tool for healing. And so as you come on this show with me, and as I share mine, I'm hoping that you're able to be healed. I'm hoping that many people are able to be healed from any church hurt, you know, but it's going to come from acknowledging that feeling. The next step I found is really helpful to overcoming any type of church hurt is really just to seek support from people in your community. I've always had, always known, and these are people who may not have necessarily gone to my church, but we have the same values. We share the same thinking, whether it's my mom, my grandma, whether it's a friend that I went to college with, somebody that I grew up with, right? Seeking that support is good. You don't want to be on this journey alone. And sometimes you can feel alone, because some churches are real clicky. I'm not seeing any church that I've gone to, but some churches are really clicky, right? Whereas if you don't show up, you ain't no longer a part of my crew, and I ain't texting you no more. I'm taking you out of the text chain. And I've been there. I've sat down with a pastor before. Let him know, hey, this is what I'm going through. I need to move into a different direction. And I got excommunicado. Excommunicado. I was like, I'm the same me, baby. I'm still me. Did I hurt you personally? Did I do something to you? Huh? Did I change? Did I tell you stop contacting me? But I got excommunicado. You know what I mean? For my John Wick fans out there. So it's good to have support, man. It's good to have people that you can connect with through these experiences. You'd be surprised how many people going through your same thing. Now, you can do it in a respectful way where you're not talking down on people. You're not talking down on the church and on the situation and discouraging people to leave with you and stuff like that. That's whack. Don't do all of that. Maybe seek a friend. Proverbs 17:17 says, a friend loves at all times, and a brother is born for a time of adversity. Embrace the love and support of those who genuinely care about your well-being. And so that's what's important to do. After you acknowledge it, embrace somebody, find out somebody that can kind of hold you through that situation. Last thing is focus on your personal growth. Focus on your personal spiritual growth. And I think that that's important when you look at where you are right now. If you're out there dealing with church hurt or considering leaving church or God, whatever, because I don't know what church you go to. You don't know what church I go to unless you know me personally. but you need to focus on your spiritual growth. Because a lot of times people will just stay at a church because that's all they've known. But if you take a look back and really kind of do a self-evaluation, like, what's good? Like, am I growing? And it's a hard question to ask yourself. Is my family growing? Like, am I in a better place? Like, is this really benefiting me, or is it just making me feel good on Sundays and possibly Wednesdays or Thursdays? Am I just around a bunch of cool people, or does God call me to more? And so that's the thing that you got to really think about. Is God calling me to more? My spiritual growth. You got to use this period that you may have kind of detached from this body of Christ or whatever, or from the church, lowercase c, of your local community. Use that period for healing and to focus on your spiritual growth. You got to rediscover your faith. You know, maybe open up a Bible plan, right? We got it all on our phones. If anybody got a little phone, you got the Bible app. They got crazy plans. You can search church hurt. You can search despair. You can search I feel alone. Whatever you would like to search, it's on there, right? Get something that you can grow from. Rediscover a love of Christ, a love of God. Listen to Maverick City. Listen to whoever you listen to for spiritual growth. Listen to Crimson and Wheat, by the way. New music coming out. Crimson and Wheat. Ooh. Make sure you do a little check on all streaming platforms. I think we got new music coming out on the 5th. January 5th. But rediscover something. Spend time in prayer. Reflect. Study the scripture independently, right? Show yourself approved. Show, you know, to God, hey, I love you. You ain't let me down. You ain't let me down in this situation. Even though I feel hurt, even though I felt somebody, you know, that was a part of the body of Christ let me down, you ain't let me down, God. So it's all good. It's all good, and I'm not tripping on that. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, therefore, if anyone be in Christ, he is a new creature. The old has gone, the new is here. Embrace the opportunity for renewal and a fresh perspective on your spiritual journey. Right? Embrace this new opportunity in this new season. Don't run from it. Don't hide from it. Don't say, all right, let me backslide since I ain't in the church. Since nobody cares anyway. See, I told you, they're not messaging me, man. I might as well just leave this whole situation. Nah. This is your time to ante up and to go harder. Right? Go harder for the things of God. Go harder for what you believe in. Go harder because God is real. God is so good. God is there even when you don't think he is. He got you through that situation in your right mind. Don't turn your back on him. I'm speaking to somebody out there. If you're thinking, if you're dealing with church hurt and you feeling like it's God's fault, don't do it. Just because a man messed you up or a woman messed you up or the ushers messed you up or the praise team leader don't let you sing the song or they stop letting you park where you wanted to park or whatever the situation, don't turn your back on God. I just speak to you right now. Don't turn your back on God. He has never turned his back on you. He is there with you in this season. There is growth. There's a testimony on the other side of this thing, my people. Right? He coming back yet? We still got time on the clock. We still got time on the clock to hit the buzzer beater. You know, I'm a Lions fan. And so in reverse, I think about the time left on the clock. I think about it in a bad way because even if we up by 15 points in the fourth quarter, if it's 2 minutes left, I feel like the Lions going to find a way to lose. That's just how I feel because I've been watching them for 40 years, right? I've been down to the Silverdome games. I've been to Ford Field for the games. I was watching, I think I watched maybe every one of the 0-16 games. I know that they'll find a way. Same thing, in reverse, God will find a way. I say that to say, God will find a way. If it's still time on the clock, if it's still breath in your body, he'll find a way to bring you out, to bring you to a better situation. Amen? Can I get an amen out there from the people? So if you are out there and you listen to this, man, I want to encourage you to consider sharing your story. I would love to have you as a guest. You can go to spotwrinkleblemish.com, and under the podcast page, you can fill out a little form. Just kind of lets me know a little bit about your story and where you are. Spot Wrinkle Blemish is a media company. that I'm over. But I plan on having people on this podcast throughout this year. They're unafraid. They're unafraid, but they also want to minister to other people through their testimony, right? They're not afraid to share their testimony. They still want to glorify God with everything that they do. If anybody's out there, you know it's G5 for life, baby. It ain't no questions, no games. When I said G5 for life at the age of 16, I meant it. It didn't matter what church I was attached to. It didn't matter who I was with. And I'm still about that thing. If you're still about that thing about glorifying God with your spirit, body, and soul, right, despite what the church did or despite what the situation was or despite who hurt you, even your husband or whoever, your wife, you might blame somebody, might blame grandma or your parents for the way they raised you, don't give up on God. I want to give a shout out real quick before I detach from this first episode, as I say. I want to give a shout out to a few key people who helped me with kind of the spark off of this thing. Shout out to my brother B. Lim. I'm looking forward to reading more of your books and kind of being a part of your journey. And I'm looking forward to having you on one of the episodes of Spot Wrinkle Blemish. I want to give a shout out to Erica, who I grew up with, kind of the church, went to college with, and I've seen you grow. And so, sister, I just appreciate you, and I would love to have you on Spot Wrinkle Blemish, the podcast, to share your testimony if you would love to. And then also my wife, Delilah, who was there as a part of this whole thing, kind of the inception of the whole thing. We're going to go on a little bit of a journey where we're able to share, break free from some things. We're able to encourage some people. We're able to minister to some people, you know, in just kind of the incoming episodes. I would love to drop maybe 2 or 3 episodes a month. One of the things I'm dealing with, man, is kind of no excuses in this next year. No excuses in 2024, right? And so what that means for me is everything that I've been putting off, everything that I said, no, but I got to work. No, but I've got this family thing. No, but I got this at church. No, I got this, right? And even, and let me just say this, since we're talking about church, you can feel like you're giving so much to the church that it kind of builds up a resentment thing in you too. Anybody ever been there, right, where you feel like you're giving so much and then you feel like, anybody know what I'm saying, right? For those who serve in the church, you kind of know what that feels like. You know, but whatever the case may be, I just want to encourage you to, you know, seek God. I want to pray for you guys real quick. Father God, I just thank you for everyone who took the opportunity to listen to this first episode, this little short, abbreviated episode of Spot Wrinkle Blemish, as my wife is calling me right now. I just thank you for their freedom in you and who you have called them to be, God. I ask that you touch the heart of the people who are supposed to be the guests. That you strengthen them and encourage them to share their testimonies, oh God, so that someone else can break free. I love you, God. I exalt you. I thank you. I want to use my gifts to serve you in all that I do, in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, my people. Episode 1 in the books. Episode 1. Make sure you subscribe. Check out Spot Wrinkle Blemish on Instagram. May pop off with a Twitter or something like that, a Threads page or something. But make sure you ultimately go to spotwrinkleblemish.com to follow along. We got new music coming from the media group. We got art probably every other day. spotwrinkleblemish.ai. In the meantime, what's up? God is still good.